Hey guys, how's it going? Today we're going to be comparing two music player apps for the iOS, for iPad and iPhone. That is Sonic Max Pro by BBE Sound and Audyssey Music Player by Audyssey Labs. And basically the aim of these music player apps is to restore the clarity of your music because you know everyone's listening to MP3s these days, which are compressed, and these apps are using some kind of algorithm to or equalization, some kind of thing to restore your sound, the highs and lows of your compressed music. At least that's what they say. So if that makes any sense, we'll see or not. At least it doesn't make sense to me. I mean, you cannot really, to me, you cannot get back what is not there. But at least these apps claim to restore some of that stuff. And I know that other companies like Creative with their X-Fi and Dolby and a whole bunch of other companies, Harman Kardon, Beats Audio, you know, they claim to do similar things with apps for the PC and stuff and mobile phones, but these are the two you can download for iOS to turn any phone or iOS device into a new music player with better quality music, supposedly. So this is what BBE Sonic Max Pro states, and on the App Store it says, BBE's critically acclaimed audio technology, Sonic Maximizer, is now available for mobile generation, hear every music, restores natural warmth, clarity, and definition that's been missing from your digital music experience. Okay, so yeah, the usual marketing jargon here. Thrill of deeper, richer low, superior clarity and definition, increased upper harmonic detail, better overall audio performance, and then play your preset, okay. No special equipment to plug in, no more downloads, you can just adjust your presets to match your music. So I assume it's some kind of algorithm or equalization behind this. And you can buy it for $2.99 right now. That's how much it costs. And then for Audyssey Music Player, Audyssey Labs is another audio company, just like BBE Sound. And what do they say? They say, the advanced Audyssey audio technologies, blah 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 blah, basically same thing, applies custom tuning profiles. The real difference between these two apps is that Audyssey Music Player, you had to buy separate profiles in addition to the main app. So you had to buy, what I mean by this is that they tailor the listening experience to the equipment you have. So say if you have a Bose Quiet Comfort 25s, a Bose SoundLink Mini versus a Beats Audio, you know, a Beats Studio, headphones, versus a Beats Pill, you know, any like different kind of Bluetooth speaker or headphones you have, that you can actually buy custom profiles for them. So that's basically another way for them to make money. They claim that it's better suited for them and stuff, though I highly doubt that it's really like that much better. But anyways, yeah, you can pick your headphone, Bluetooth speaker, individually calibrated profiles are used. You basically have to buy more, play your music, hear the difference. Alright, you never knew what you were missing. Okay, well, we'll test this out. And this is available for free, of course. So you have to, it's available for free, but it's not really free because you have to buy the custom profiles and stuff, which are like 99 cents each, I think. So say you have like a SoundLink Mini and a Sennheiser Momentum like me, then you have to buy those separately for 99 cents. So yeah, let's test the Audyssey Music Player versus the Sonic Max Pro. Keep in mind that I don't think the Sonic Max Pro works on they don't have an iPad version yet, so I'm just going to use the iPhone version for my iPad, and I'll be testing it using my speaker over here. That's both Bluetooth, but I plugged the aux in so you can hear the difference better. It's my Sound Blaster, Creative Sound Blaster Roar 2, hooked up to my iPad. Okay, so this is what the BBE Sonic Max Pro looks like. And this is the iPhone version, that's why it looks weird here, but it should still work in principle. It uses the same app, right? So on iOS, yeah, it's basically enhances your music player a little bit different than your standard iPad music app or iPhone music app. And let's listen. Here's the main thing. We have some settings here, and I have it. You can actually custom tailor it. You can actually have different devices here. Now the real thing I don't like about this interface is that you have to select it to know what it is. Like, I don't know, what is the difference between this and this? Aren't they both docks? But apparently one of them is a clock radio and the other one is a dock, and there's apparently a profile difference between the two. which I don't know about, and there's even soundbars, and I've never actually seen the iPod soundbar dock before, but apparently they're there. And what's this? Isn't this just another dock? Nope, apparently it's a home music system. So, yeah, I don't know. I'm just going to use the external speaker profile. And, yeah, we have all these settings here, but I'll just keep them at the standard setting. But it's pretty much just the equalization. So that's the BBE Sonic Max Pro. What's interesting is if you compare this with the Audyssey Music Player app. So this is a BBA Sound Pro, right? And let me switch to the other app here, the Audyssey Music Player. That's it right here. So this is the Audyssey Music Player. So it's a little bit different because you have to add different profiles depending on the equipment you're using. So I'm going to pick the SoundLink Mini. I know this is not a SoundLink Mini, but it's the closest thing I have to one. It's certainly not a headphone. But anyways, it should be quite similar because it is a speaker, an external speaker. And you can actually, you had to browse all these rest and stuff. I'm not sure if my brand is even here. Do I have my brand here? Creative? No, I don't. So I don't have a choice. They don't have the Creative Sound Blaster Roar. So I'm going to pick the Bose SoundLink Mini. It's a good approximation. Sounds like there's a little bit more bass with it turned on, a little bit, but you can't really see exactly the settings because it's not as fine detailed as this. Like this, you can actually, the BBE Sonic Max Pro, you can actually fine tune the settings with bass, gain, contour, etc. Whereas with the Audyssey Music Player, you don't really have a choice here. You just get whatever default thing they give you here. But actually, I think there might be. Okay, here, we do have a thing to personalize your sound. Okay, so you can add more bass and treble, you can add more highs and more lows. Let's try doing that. Let's try another song, actually. How about some Beatles? I always love Beatles. Alright. Let's try this song, it's one of my favorites.